everybody. It's Michelle Patterson here with Angel Souls, and this is our daily card reading for September 9th, 2020. All right, angelic help is on the way. So we have Celestia, soothe your soul. Notice everything that has been coming up the past, what, 5 days, 4 days, something like that, where it's been all about, we cannot pretend like this isn't happening anymore. And what a lot of people want to do, I'm hearing right now, is like they're engaging in escapism. I'm an angel medium. I have people come to me for readings and they don't want to make a move in their life until the angels tell them what to do. And then they're stunned when they get some clarification instead. This is where you are. Here are the lessons you're here to learn. And they walk away going, yeah, but you didn't tell me what to do. We need to look at that, all right? So this isn't about, you know, leaning on your angels in the respect that they're supposed to dictate your every move, but rather leaning on your spiritual team, your angels, your spirit guides, to help you remember who you really are. That the little mishaps that happen around your home, you know, it's not something to put your whole, you know, energy into and get stuck on the surface. There's something far deeper that is occurring, and it has to do with healing the entire human race and to heal humanity. And if we are still playing escapism and trying to pretend like those things aren't happening, that we don't want to go deep, we're afraid of what's there. So you stay on the surface, you get obsessed over a love partner, or a home, or a job, or your career path, or a book you're writing. You get so obsessed over that. That is just surface level. Soothe your soul is an invitation to calm that story, to calm the energy storm that's happening inside of you when you do engage in those kinds of things, when you get stressed. Happens to me all the time. And I end up not eating well that day. I end up not exercising that day. I'm in a bad mood. Or just a frustrated mood. That's what I would call it. Just frustrated. And then I have to stop and evaluate. This is just one example. I have to stop and evaluate and go, what am I doing? What would I really like to do? Well, I want to take my, you guys are going to laugh. I'm going to start putting these in the videos. I have these, I started a weird hobby here, and I'll tell you in a second, but I just want a pot of tea. I want to sit out on my pretty balcony, and I just want to look at the sky, and I want to feel the wind, and I don't want to think about all the stuff that I have to get done. I don't want to have to worry about what's to come next. I just need a minute. And that's what we're talking about when we say soothe your soul. Unplug from the surface level story every once in a while and give yourself a chance to remember that real part of you. Now, the weird hobby I picked up, I suddenly started getting into teapots. I had to catch myself the other day because I'm like, okay, I am officially over 40. Like, I've been over 40 for a few years now, but like, I'm finally catching up with my over 40 self. I found myself wrapped in a pashmina, and I had art supplies, but not for painting. It was for Mod Podging paper, making this thing right here, this little reading board that doubles as artwork when I'm not using it. And I sat with my historical replica porcelain, it's not China, porcelain teapot and teacup, and just sitting outside and being like, this is delightful. Having thoughts like, this is delightful, okay? Like, wow. And you know what? I've never been happier. I've never been happier. Actually, I've got my teacup right here. Here's one of them. I'm having a little cup of tea. Let's just leave it there. I'm sending you so much love and take care. Bye-bye.